Hey fellow Vault Dwellers, it's Angry Turtle and I'm coming back with another video. This time we are taking closer look on Hellstorm Missile Launcher, the new toy that we are getting from Steel Dawn update. Non-legendary of course, as obtaining a legendary version will take a lot of time. But this out of the way, is this weapon bugged or working as intended? That's the biggest question ever that we'll attempt to answer. I mean, I will not be able to answer, but you will help me and tell me if it's bugged or if it should be like that. I'm clueless and I will tell you why. That's the part that I can explain. And now, first what we need to do. We unequip all those heavy gunner perks and demolition expert. And I'm full health as well, then we removed most of the buffs. Okay, I will remove as well Bloody Mess. Standard barrel, 200 damage. And now we compare it to the Recon Missile Launcher, 321. You can see it's quite behind in damage, but there are some details into it. Really, really weird stuff going on. And let's start on it. Perks. I will equip some heavy gunner perks now. Okay, let us in Heavy Gunner, Expert Heavy Gunner, not the Lock and Load, Master Heavy Gunner. And now, our Hellstorm Missile Launcher is doing 320, and Recon Missile Launcher 321. We have about the same damage. Almost exactly the same damage, alright. But that's not the weird stuff yet. Let's equip Demolition Expert. Kick out Gunsmith. Demolition Expert in, and now 397 versus 507. Regular Missile Launcher is showing much higher damage, but it's not exactly the case. After field testing, the Hellstorm Missile Launcher is doing more damage, even though it stays less on the card. And what I was able to figure out, Hellstorm Missile Launcher, even if it's not modded with any elemental mod, is applying two hits. Like, it's not just one hit, it's two different impacts. Two different type of explosions. I don't know how to explain it, how they coded it. I have no clue. But then to prove the point, let's unequip Demolition Expert again. Now you'll be able to see the damage, almost the same. And now what we do, we equip the Bloody Mess. And now we look at the damage again, and Recon Missile Launcher is doing again higher damage. That's because with this launcher, we have two different hits and only one is boosted by conventional perks and other parts is boosted only by those explosive perks. I don't know, it's very weird stuff going on there. It's like the damage boosts are not applying in the same way to regular Missile Launcher and to Hellstorm Missile Launcher. But let's equip the perks again and let's shoot it a little bit. Okay, we have some targets. First the doggo. And you see? If you look closely or if you will attempt to play it in slow motion, you will be able to see there are two explosions on top of each other. Those are actually two hits, not just one. Look at this guy. And even by the damage number, you can see two damage numbers popping up on the screen. Even though I'm just keep firing this weapon on him, I'm not using VATS to multiply it. Now I can use VATS. It's still two explosions. Then it killed this doggo. And okay, let's shoot one more super mutant with this missile launcher. Level 60, this time in VATS. You can see that his health is dropping twice. He's getting hit twice. Now we swap to regular missile launcher. I heal just to be consistent with full health build. And I hit him. Oh, that's the VATS sometimes with regular missile launcher. It went through. Now I hit him. In VATS, it's still hitting like almost twice. Because here, yeah, VATS and explosions, weird interaction. Without VATS, yeah, you can see that first damage is 2. And second damage is the high damage. But in case of Hellstorm Missile Launcher, both damage are significant. Here, if I hit him, you can see that 2, it's the impact damage, and a second damage is much higher. In case of Hellstorm Missile Launcher, I think the impact damage is more like a heavy gun, regular heavy gun, and then explosion is added on top. Oh, I missed now. There was only one damage number. But let me find another one and we hit directly. You will see the impact damage, both the impact damage and the explosions are significant. You can see that there's 136, 162. In VATS, I almost kill him. It's the explosion is still twice. There's impact damage and two explosions. If I go for the regular missile launcher again and I shoot him, you can see it's like expected, less damage. Even though on the weapon card, regular missile launcher is the highest damage dealer. But in practice, when I shoot it, yeah, it's lower. Regardless if I shoot it in VATS or not. Now, how much Hellstorm missile launcher will do if I do not shoot directly and just aim at his legs? I think it's doing less, yeah. He actually healed. Come on, stop doing that, Super Mutant. We are trying to test something. You are not allowed to magically heal. Okay, again, at the ground. He was hit by only one, I think, damage number. He's not healing now. Okay, he's good. He's not healing now. If I hit him in the torso, yeah, that's way more damage. He just died. Then it's looked like Hellstorm missile launcher have some hidden impact damage similar to a heavy gun, and on top of that there is an explosion, unlike it is in case of normal missile launcher where impact damage is non-existent and you just have a huge portion that's an explosion. Then that's what's weird about this launcher, and as well, it's slightly cheaper in VATS. Then it's a good weapon for VATS users. Still super crazy heavy ammo and stuff like that. And we have this scope. Look really cool, but how practical it is, I don't know. I can try to snipe him, but still, projectiles are slow. It requires target to stand still. Now let's take a closer look on possible modifications. First, for those of you that do not know, let me show you regular missile launcher, what it offers. There is basically standard barrel, only one missile. It can up it up to 4 missile. Slight loss of durability, improvement to the fire rate and ammo capacity, because clearly from 1 to 4, that's a huge improvement. Then you can put standard sight scope, night vision scope, and targeting computer. What's awesome on missile launcher, it allows you to play with it and have great fun. Just mark the target, then shoot straight into the air and missile will follow. That's really cool. Then there is couple muzzles. I don't know if anyone is using them, but both are reducing durability. And as you know, durability on missile launchers is terrible, including Hellstorm missile launcher. I started testing with full bar. It's already almost empty and you were able to see how many times I shot. Like, it wasn't a lot. We shoot couple enemies, that's it. Then durability is terrible, and it's hard to include both demo expert and gunsmith and some other perks under intelligence. That's what's problematic. But yeah, let's just keep a note about bad durability and carry on. About the barrels here, it's some cool stuff. At this moment it's showing less damage as I equip gunsmith to be older to mod it. Some mods for the missile launcher requires gunsmith. Normally it's about the same, both are about the same. You will see after I mod it. But first, we have cryo payload. This is cool, it slows down enemy. Then we have enhanced blast payload. That's a higher ammo capacity. Okay, I will put it for a moment to show the ammo capacity. I'm low on aluminum. And now this enhanced ammo capacity is just two more missile. And it slightly changed the look of your missile launchers. You can see there's 6 cylinders now and just one on front, and they then can rotate and shoot one after another missile. Faster fire rate and 2 more missile. But the price is less damage. I will not probably recommend it. Like, missile are already super heavy. Improving fire rate for cost in damage, it's probably not the best thing you can do with missile launcher. Then after that we have napalm payload that just do flame damage. It doesn't heal your ally, therefore I will not recommend to use it. Unless you just like Molotov cocktail animation, because it's very similar to that. Then we have plasma payload that's doing just energy damage and supposed to be, thanks to that, the highest damage payload. Although it is not quite the case. I will put it on now and you will see what this plasma payload will be doing. About the scopes, unfortunately, there is no targeting computer to be found anywhere. I have all mods unlocked, no targeting computer. There's night vision scope, recon scope, and standard sights possible. And yes, every scope is reducing your durability and slightly increasing AP cost. Then you should think twice if you want to use any, as most likely you will not be sniping with it. But I wanted to show you the scope. Then you were able to see the scope already. I'm going back to standard sights. All right, let's make sure I'm full health and we have another super mutants. Let's shoot them with this payload, plasma payload. It's supposed to be the highest damage. Let's see if it's the case. Let me make sure that I have demo expert and not gunsmith. Yes, let's swap it. All right, let's see what now. Oh, it's actually lower level super mutant, just level 50. Let's shoot him. And you can see it's not like level 50 survive in VATS. I need 2 shots. That means I have less damage. Without VATS, survive as well. I don't know why they are lower level in here, but they surviving in VATS, and level 50 super mutants are much more squishy than level 60 or 75. Can we have higher level? No. Then let's compare it with a regular missile launcher that was doing less damage before. If I shoot him now, you can see it's the same damage without VATS even. Then you can clearly see that changing the payload is giving you extra crispy animation, but actually reducing your damage output. Then I don't know why this is supposed to be beneficial to put like plasma or something like that. You can see the green stuff everywhere, and it's really like, if you are using scope, then after you fire you will not be able to see a thing. That's one of the weird stuff that's going on with this missile launcher. Like, if you don't touch any mods, it seems to be the best possible missile launcher. Then why do we have so many mods to buy when best mods are already installed and those are standard mods? Maybe something that you can consider, those are snowballs. Let's install the snowball mod. Okay, and now we have a snowballs modification installed. We'll not be testing a fire one because fire one is just different animation and no slowdown effect. Apart from that, it's not doing anything else than snowballs will be doing. The damage is the same. The fire one is the one you shouldn't be using unless you like the animation. And now let's heal up again to be consistent. Let's find those super mutants and shoot them with snowballs this time. And we have level 60 and above. That's good. Then snowball, 1 hit, 2 hit in VATS. Keep in mind that 3 hits. 3 hits with a snowball to take level 60 super mutant down. Full health, but fully spec'd for damage, apart from adrenaline, because I don't want my damage to keep changing. There is demo expert, there is bloody mess, and all the heavy gunner perks. Now level 75 Doggo. Hit. Doggo are more squishy. Then I just need 2 Messiah. This one somehow missed, and the problem is if you shoot close, you cannot see a thing. Like, look at that. Everything is white and black and white and gray. Yeah, for a moment you are totally blinded. Now another level 60, then let's hit him with a regular missile launcher. Let's see what will be the difference. Okay, in VATS, real easy to hit. Therefore, going for the snowball modification, we lost further damage. Like, plasma is already losing you damage. If you go to different modification, you're losing even more damage. Then whatever you modify, every mod is losing damage for you. Then how is it beneficial? I don't know, but every modification is losing the damage. Level 75, you see 1 hit, 2 hits, and 3 hits as well. And those are double hits, all of them. You can see it's still hitting twice, but the second damage is much smaller now because they're quite resistant to the frost damage and fire damage. Therefore, I lost more damage. I can shoot him in the head, and here we have quite high impact damage. Therefore, headshots have a reason. If critical, killed. And I cannot see a thing for a moment. It's good to blind your enemies, I think, but don't know if that's the main point of using this rocket launcher. And now for the final test, as you can see, I drop my health, I'm in the Nerd Rage, I have all the perks equipped, including, of course, Nerd Rage, Adrenaline, Tenderizer, everything is in here to boost this damage. At this moment, Hellstorm is showing 640, regular Messiah is showing over 1000, but trust me, this 640 is more, as I proved already, because there is like... have two different components, impact and additional damage from explosion, then somehow it is more, like 600 is more than 1000. I don't know how, but it is truth. And we'll see if we can deal better with super mutants, and then we try to fight a Scourge Beast to see if we can use this weapon. And we have a big guy as well. Let's see a regular super mutant first on the torso. Yes, I can one-shot them. And yeah, keep firing. The problem is, if they sidestep, the Messiah is slow enough that I will miss. But if I hit, yeah, it's one shot. Even though the damage numbers that are showing on the screen are not impressive, they are dying in one shot. Let's see if we can deal with the big guy. Okay, big guy, how much damage we can do to you? Yeah, we can deal with him, although it's not like, I would not say it's impressive. I need like 6 Messiah fully boosted, all the perks and everything in here to put him down, but regular super mutants, 1 Messiah. Now, what about the Scourge Beast? Here we go, Scourge Beast is waiting for us. Can we do any damage when she's in air? Can use critical actually to guarantee hit. And 1 Messiah hit, and this critical did some damage. Man, hit her. We hit her twice, we did a little bit of damage. It's, I would not say it's impressive, but at least it's something. It's not like zero damage. Run out of VATS and wasted some Messiah flying who knows where. Okay, let's kill those Scourge. Oh, somehow level 100 Scourge was able to survive. Don't know how. Oh, on the ground, how well we can do now. I shoot 2 Messiah, only 1 hit. That's not perfect. Alright, I killed her. I'm not impressed with the damage though, but I killed her. Now, is it bugged? Is it intended? It's a question for you guys. Should it work like that? 2 different damage impacts, explosion and impact damage, and totally not following the rules of other launchers, have its own rules. It's doing more damage than on weapon card, then that's good, because if this will be damage that's on weapon card, this will be the worst ever missile launcher in this game. Now at least it can compete with regular one, but only if you don't mod it. After you put any mods on it, it's instantly going to be a rubbish. Then that's a problem, like you pay gold bullion to buy those modifications and they render your missile launcher almost useless. That's the Hellstorm missile launcher compared with regular missile launcher. And now, as always, thank you a lot for watching and see you guys in the next one.